Hi, Opie and Anthony show. It's a snow day. Yay. We're all here, everybody but Steve C. Who still, I guess, is... do we have the distance report on Steve C yet? He was at 100 feet away from his house because of the snow here in New York. 100 and... What do you think about? 10, 15 feet? I'm still trying.
I would say 107.
107 feet.
Yes.
Damn.
I don't think he's going to make it in.
No?
I don't think he's going to make it in today.
He's going to try.
Steve trying means he's not going to make it in.
Have we heard from him?
No. Hasn't called back.
No.
Oopsie.
I've gone back to bed. I've left my Prius in the snow. I had to make it back. It was whiteout conditions. Well, we have a giant fucking debut today, by the way.
Yeah, it's time for the premiere.
Man.
It's the only reason we came to work today.
Yeah.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. So, Sam, what do we got going on? We made our own version of We Are the World. You and Troy and the guys behind the scenes have been working on this for the last 2 weeks, I think.
Yes.
Week and a half, whatever.
This is a giant undertaking. The initial We Are the World, of course, you know, that was back in, what, 85? 25 years ago. So for the 25th anniversary, they got together a whole new group of the stars du jour and some classic stars, got them in the studio and did a new version. And we listened and went, ha-ha, are you kidding me? We could do better than that.
Mm-hmm.
So we gathered up the various lunatics, psychopaths, losers, loners, homeless, and, of course, just some of the characters from the show, and did our own version for the 25th anniversary.
And this song is historic for two reasons.
Ooh. Oh, okay.
Number one, we still have to confirm this. Mm. It may be the longest produced bit in O&A history.
Ooh, which means we like it.
Yeah. So you can play it three or four times.
Nice.
How about it's the first produced bit in over seven years?
Yeah, that's another one. That's another record.
We haven't produced a bit in over 7 years.
Number two, we believe it to be the first produced bit that all three members, Opie, Anthony, and Jim Norton of the show, are on.
Actually on? Wow.
Which means we were able to get all three members after the show to record something.
Holy shit.
So give yourselves a round of applause.
What a huge undertaking that is.
Did any of us have their coats off?
Okay.
No.
Yeah, that's true. We all did our parts with our coats on. I was actually holding my bag in my hand.
Yeah.
Well, my scrotum,
of course.
Yeah, because I sing better that way.
There will be a video. Really, all parts were filmed. So
fantastic.
This is going to be an official video?
Official video.
Ooh. There will be a video.
Will it be edited nicely with some nice fade, because I want this thing to look really professional.
Yeah, I just have to get some, mountainous B-roll and some eagles.
Oh, that would be good. And how about starving children?
And some starving children.
Okay, E-Rock.
And, well...
Wow. That's what I mean, starving children.
Yeah, I just get him in the office grabbing his belly, going, oh.
Yeah, just get people with hunger pain.
Now this was weeks in the making.
Yeah.
I
mean, we had the idea as soon as We Are the World 25 was announced, we started brainstorming.
Yeah.
We decided to wait until the release of the song so we could get a feel for it.
Uh-huh.
Once we played it on the air here, we knew it was time to start working.
Do we have a list of the participants, or can you, off the top of your head, name some of the giant celebrities and stars from this very program that participated in this historic event, I would call it?
Well, I mean, you'll hear Anthony and Opie, of course.
Wow, yes.
Uncle Paul.
Ah.
Ted Sheckler.
Must have been hard getting him in.
Yeah. Lyle Chipperson is on it.
Oh, Lyle Chipperson.
Homeless Mustard. Stalker Patty. Yes, we heard that.
Yeah,
Big A.
Big
Bobo,
A.
Bobo. Roland.
Roland?
The Virus.
Wait a minute, the virus?
The virus is on it. Tank Hankerus is on it.
Isn't that redundant?
Well, Tank Hankerus and the virus appear back to back on the song.
So,
that's awesome.
All right, I'm gonna really have to keep an ear open to see when the change happens, because I've noticed, can you say one trick pony as far as a voice impressions
it's
go?
Just a different voice with the same material.
And if you keep your ears open, there's some voices from the past towards the end of the song.
I think people are going to have to listen to this a couple times to pick up on everybody that's in this.
Well, absolutely.
Wasn't that the fun of the original We Are the World? It's like I think that's Steve Perry.
There was nothing fun about it.
Nothing at all. What am I saying?
Hopefully ours brings a little fun.
And I've listened to it several times already. And if what's fun is the way it's produced in the chorus.
Yeah.
Everybody's separated, and some people pan to the left, some to the right. So you can hear the separate voices. So every time you listen, you can listen for someone else's voice.
Are you trying to tell me that this is a stereo?
Yeah,
Sorry, Pal Dog Baby, you're only getting right. So you've missed you're missing half the song.
You'll miss some voices.
Yes.
Well, let's do it.
Listen to it,
man.
On satellite. Go fuck yourselves.
Yeah, exactly. Help us out. Get a little satellite. Are we ready for this?
I am.
Do we have the big production piece to tell everyone once again how great we are?
Oh, good.
Because we tell everyone how great we are every morning, right, Ant?
That's what we do. Go listen to Opie and Anthony. They say how great they are. I like that. That ought to be a promo.
I think it should be a promo.
Yeah.
But we're not allowed to play other people's audio, unfortunately.
Well, we'll just make it a promo for ourselves.
Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da. Let's play the production piece, and let's do this. The premiere of the Opie and Anthony version of We Are the World.
And now, the Opie and Anthony Show proudly presents...
We Are the World!
The world premiere of Opie and Anthony's We Are the World.
That's it?
That's a bit, and then you guys go,
It should
kick
lasers.
In right there.
There's explosions.
There's some explosions.
I like explosions, but no lasers.
There's some reverb on the voice.
It should have been a little more over the top, I'm thinking.
A little more lasers.
Sounds like someone threw that piece together last minute because they didn't really want to do it for us.
Yes. So,
somebody didn't want to do it.
Really? Yes.
Really? just was annoyed that we were bothering them.
Yeah.
Here's the song.
No, we can't tell them the way to something. Right now, they need a helping hand or foot. or maybe shoulders.
Nothing but love! we're making. Yes, we're saving our own lives. It's true, we'll make a gayer day, just you and me. See, I'm gay.
Well, you're down and out, and there seems no hope at all. But if you just believe, there's no way we could fall. When we stand together as one.
Give yourself a feel.
We are the world. We are the children. We are the ones who make better things. So let's start here. Don't live, not kill them.
There's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives. It's true. We'll make a better day, just you and me.
There's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives.
Better day, just you and me.
Come on now, let me hear you. We are the world. We are the children. We are the ones who make a brighter day. Plus, this God's giving.
You know, folks, there's a lot of big dicks in the world, and I blew a lot of them, and I'll tell you, big dicks leave a bad taste in my mouth.
Wow.
I'm stupefied.
I
what do you think? What do you think?
I'm too tearing. I'm tearing up here at the beauty.
Well, bravo to Sam
that,
and Troy and everyone else.
What a production
that
piece that is.
And the funny thing is, Club Soda Kenny was really, really mad that you were auto-tuning
him. Auto-tuning him.
But that could be the best part of the whole fucking song.
I love the auto-tune part. Yeah. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Well, we're going to have to play that
epic.
A few more times.
Epic. We have to make it available for download somewhere.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, but only the difference is we will pay you to download it instead of the way it usually works.
Well, fucking greatest fucking song fucking ever. That's
well,
from Awful Me from Wagbag.
Of course.
Blue Healer, it's not the clusterfuck I thought it would be.
I don't know if that's good or bad.
I think that's a good review. I want an iTunes link now.
Yeah, we got to get that
that's
up.
That's Coco in the D. Please don't play that again. I'm ashamed for you. It sounds like a zoo crew when you fabulous. I don't know. All right, punching out. Sounds like the Muppet Show.
It kind of did a little bit, a little Muppety.
Muppet Show. Hey, what's wrong with that?
That's what they sound like.
Yeah.
It's just what they sound like.
Sound like Muppets. Let's see. Thank God you guys don't do bits anymore. How many guest Muppets did you get from Sesame Street?
Wow. They don't know
Redding Muppets says that's a piece of shit and the funniest piece of shit ever.
Oh, good.
But Kenny with the auto-tune was funny.
Mm-hmm.
So, you're going to have to hear it again. There's a lot of people in there. Like,
yeah.
I heard Tim at the end. That,
yes.
That has to be a little bit of a surprise from
that's
our
amazing.
K-Rock days. You know, the, oh, no, guy.
A simple two-word review coming in. Shit sandwich.
Shit sandwich.
Again, I don't know if that's good or bad.
Yes, E-Rock.
There's one point towards the end of the song where everybody's in the chorus. If you listen real closely, right after they sing We Are the World, Uncle Paul goes, let's take our clothes off.
Also, see, it's those little moments.
I didn't
moments
hear that. You got to hear it again. There's also Uncle Paul. He has another line. It's hidden in there, but he says, there's a choice we're making. We're ruining all their lives.
I didn't hear that either.
It's in there. See, that's fantastic.
We'll play it. We'll definitely play it again in a little while. Yeah. We're going to play it two more times during the show just so people could listen to it.
Of course.
Bill in Texas, what's up?
Whoa, Bill.
Hello, ONA, Party Rock. Awesome, guys. Awesome. I want to know, where do I send the check?
Yeah, I know. People just hear that, and they just want to donate to something.
Yeah, you
know,
that is the best piece of work I've ever heard, guys.
You know, definitely. As a goof, we wanted to put it online and make people, like, download it for, like, whatever.
Yeah.
And oh, really send the money idea to charity, but we found out we're not allowed to do that.
How come we're
they
not
don't
allowed
want our money, I guess.
How come we're not allowed to
once
do
again,
that,
once again, a charity doesn't want our money.
I wonder why we're not allowed to do that.
Just as a goof, we put it up on iTunes. It would, people would download it just to help the damn Haiti thing out, or maybe we do it, you know, for help out America or something.
Homeless or something.
Why not? But they said no because why?
We can never help.
We don't own the rights to the music.
Yeah, but
get fucking like Quincy
charity.
Jones on the phone.
It's charity.
That's what I would think. I mean, we're
and
keeping
it's parody.
Mm-hmm.
It's parody charity.
Yeah.
So parody, you
parody
can do.
Charity.
Parody's like protected, right?
What?
Hello?
hold on. Stephen S. from Bayshore, exactly how long is that song? It seemed to last about 19 minutes. Wayne in Boston, Bobo was just excellent. Give him the nod.
Oh.
Sounds a lot like the retarded version of Hungry Eyes.
That's good.
Keith from Philly, I heard Uncle Paul scream children.
Yes.
I love how brilliantly it was edited for the chorus. It sounded like everyone stepped all over each other. Fucking hilarious.
Yeah, it really was. Just a clusterfuck.
When are you going to play the ONA version? Where's the video? This guy just writes blink, blink, humpex.
Mm.
Bravo, boys. Those fuckers can produce.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I don't know.
A lot more positive than negative coming in on this one.
If you ask me, I say it's a hit.
I think it's a hit, and I think the people that are bitching about it are haters.
Well, yeah.
They're just haters.
And Evan from Fort Drum, the small change in E-Rock's voice with Tank Hankless and the virus was fucking hysterical.
Yeah, that, my favorite part right there.
Yeah.
Is the virus and Tank Hankless and the absolute impossibility of distinguishing the two.
But that's the beauty of a song like this, is everybody's going to have a different favorite part, and your favorite parts are going to change.
Yes, and then you'll notice things that you missed the first 18 times.
People picking up on, Poe got in there with us.
Little us was in there.
I wanted to laugh, but I cried. It was that touching. What happened to super affected Mustard? Mustard sounded fucking great.
Yeah,
I guess we got a nice version of Mustard this time around.
He was our Bieber.
He didn't do that, though.
He went
straight
in the chorus.
Okay.
Yeah, it's hidden in the chorus.
Great job, Troy Kwan and Sam. I love the... we did that one. Tippy Tom made it.
Yeah, what was Tippy Tom was in the end. I just pulled him. I put him in singing If You Want My Body.
See, I didn't even notice that part. I'm going to have to listen and... I didn't notice Tippy Tom in there, a tribute.
He was the last voice.
Instead of an official video, Blue Healer, I think everyone's thinking this, Coke Logic's got to animate that. That would be
Oh, my God. Yeah, that would be quite an undertaking.
We can put up a video of the recording to give Coke Logic some time to animate it.
Yeah. Okay, we'll do that.
Oh, would that be amazing.
Listen to the words, man. why did Tank Hankara sound like the Cookie Monster, Reverend Al wants to know.
A little bit. Yeah, a little bit. That's, I guess, what the Muppet thing was.
Love Big A getting stuck in the word start.
Yeah, yes. That was good. He finally got it out as the other person was already singing.
The entire chorus had
the chorus had started, and he finally got
Sean
his line
from
out.
Albany, Georgia. Tim being back equals best part. Finally, something that ranks lower on Rotten Tomatoes than Cop Out.
These are retards singing, and that's
motion picture up to now.
We told you we don't have time to talk about Cop Out today. I hate. When
I just
want
to see what it's. Up
I really
to
wanted
on
to
Rotten
talk
Tomatoes.
About Cop Out on our radio show, but we just don't have time.
It's snow day. We have so much going on.
Yeah. All right, it ticked up a notch.
All right, it's
went
up to 14%
to 14%
positive reviews. Let's see. I'm absolutely crying. The review's just coming in. You want some phone calls?
Oh, who doesn't? After this,
let's
please.
Go to Keith the Trucker. Keith.
Hey, Keith.
Yeah, guy, I'm absolutely crying over here. That was fucking hysterical, man. It started off so serious and sweet with the homeless dude, and then it all went to shit, man. That was fucking great.
Kenny coming in right after that is just...
That was perfect.
Really set the mood.
That was perfect. My favorite part might be Kenny auto-tune.
Yeah.
Fucking great job, Sam. You need a pay raise, dude.
Yeah, we got to get Sam.
The overuse of the auto-tune, too, was really good.
Of course.
It was not subtle.
Pitches up.
Yeah, it was not a subtle use of
Kenny was walking around here dead serious, shaking his head like, I don't want to be auto-tuned.
You're ruining my magic.
He doesn't understand how great it is to have him auto-tuned.
He made me sign a napkin that said he would receive $1,000 in cash if he were auto-tuned. So I made him record it, and then I wiped my ass with a napkin.
Oh, good. Let's say hi to Trucker Brendan. Trucker Brendan.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
I fucking love it. Opie, I heard you. Kenny auto-tuned is excellent, just like he did in Fireflies. Anthony, did you have a solo?
I was doing the, if you notice, the pseudo Bruce Springsteen yelling in the chorus.
That was awesome.
The, we are the world!
He also did Steve C.
Yeah, that was not the actual Steve C.
Yeah, Anthony did Steve C.
Steve C voice, yes.
I gotcha.
See, everyone's saying they would definitely pay, like, whatever, $1 or $2 on iTunes. And we wouldn't want the money. We'd fucking make some money for some dumb charity.
Well, I'll see. I'll talk to the lawyers and see if there's any way to get it up.
The lawyers. Well, that'll be great. They'll probably make it so we can't even play it on the air.
Yeah, that's
what they'll do. As a matter of fact, don't play it on the air. Destroy any copy of it and kill everyone involved with it. Thank you.
They're still deciding if we could replay the homeless Charlie bit, by the way. That's what the lawyers have been up to for the last 2 weeks.
Knocking that one around it's a fucking trial of the century.
It's just a throwaway. We're like, you know what? It's time to replay homeless Charlie that got us almost fired and suspended for 30 days.
Yeah.
And they're still batting it around, deciding if we could replay something that already aired, by the way.
You know, so many people are saying they would absolutely pay 99 cents for it if it goes to charity. Well, you know something? We got to figure out a way.
We should.
We could look like good guys for once.
There was no one ever wants our charity money.
I know.
There was one.
Get the black homeless minority Vietnam
vets.
Yeah, get them. They'll take our money.
There was one person who had a chance to be on this recording.
And said no?
That flaked out.
Who?
Shitty intern David.
What the fuck is with that guy?
He just no-showed and stopped responding to emails.
Wow.
And that was actually Club that he was supposed to follow muster, and Club Soda Kenny got his line.
Someone better go to Central Park. He might be dead like Boner's dead.
Oh. Maybe he's a Cohen or a Cohen or Cohen,
whatever
called.
Ian said yesterday.
Cohen. We tried to get a sax solo for me and Halperin.
Oh, and how great would that happened? Have been?
He said he was on location.
He's living out of a suitcase.
Living
we wanted
suitcase.
One part of the song to go, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ian Halperin.
Oh, and a sax solo. Oh.
Yeah. Let's go to Reed in D.C. Reed.
Maybe next 25 years anniversary, we'll do that.
Reed.
Gentlemen, that part of the song, Big A, getting hung up on... Nobody waited for him.
Nobody waited. That really is funny, man.
I can't wait to hear it again because I got to pick up on some more shit.
Yeah.
Brian, Connecticut.
Guys, I loved it. Favorite part? Give yourself a bell.
Yeah, I missed that, too.
Really?
Wow.
They didn't know what.
I'm listening to the chorus. There's so much going on.
It was pretty sad when they realized they didn't know what I could do for the song. I'm like, all right.
There were no characters.
Yeah, I do characters. Mike in Buffalo. Mike?
Yes. Uncle Paul can sing. And when did Ted Sheckler get out of the shower and start singing? You guys should give Ted Sheckler a record deal.
That's true. Ted, really powerful voice on Ted, by the way.
He does. He was actually, he had to be brought down in the chorus because
Ted was overpowering everybody. Yeah. That Ted Sheckler does like to sing.
Well, I'll tell you this much. A lot of people are commenting about the damn thing.
Yeah.
It's a newsmaker.
I love it. I know. When's the news going to pick this up?
Can we give it to another channel around here? Any channels willing to play our version of We Are the World?
What about the Morning Mashup? Yeah. They should play it.
The Morning Mashup probably would play it, except for that Sandy Kane line in the end. You know, folks, there's a lot of big dicks in the world.
We have to get a radio edit
Yeah.
where it's beeped.
Yeah,
and I've blown a lot.
Then I've blown a lot of people. Why did she have to tell that story? Why did she just come out and tell that story?
I just went around the room and I was like, "All right, guys, just give me some ad libs and stuff." I was like, "Sandy, give me like a dick joke. Give me something." And she just starts going, "You know, folks,
that's what I suck a lot of dicks."
But she sells it perfectly.
She's great. Really does. She's great.
You know,
of course she does.
What the fuck? We missed. Oh, Ron in Toronto, Ron.
Yeah, it's Ross from Toronto. I was waiting for my toodly-doo, so...
Yeah, what happened to the toodly-doo? I thought that was going to make it in
yeah,
there.
Yeah, we never got a toodly-doo. I just thought it would be too much,
yeah,
to tell you the truth.
There was a lot that we had to leave out because there was so much
just
to
so
put
much
in
there. It would have been buried and just mishmash. It's just a perfect mix of the talent and the music. Yeah. I think you hit it right on
and
the head.
And we can always remix it.
Yeah.
And... You never were going to get me twice to go into that fucking
that
studio.
That was the main problem.
When I was racing toward the elevator.
We almost got blown off the first time. We were not going to get a second
that
time.
That is true. Yes. That is true.
Chicago, what do you got today, buddy?
Hey, that was brilliant, man. I loved it.
See?
Cool. I was wondering if maybe you guys could put a list out of like who's on there, because there's like so much stuff going by.
Sam, can you give me I'll put it on my Twitter. We'll put it on all our Twitters, because I don't know who you guys are following. Some are, whatever. Give me a list. In order of who appears, and I'll at least tweet that before we play it again in the next... we'll play it again, like, real soon.
Okay.
We'll play it again at 9 o'clock. How's that?
That's huge.
I was not in the room with Sandy Kane and Mustard at the same time. No.
No, we all kind of did it separately.
I did my parts alone.
There was only one recording where you had about six or eight guys in the fishbowl. And then after that, it was everyone just doing it individually, and then they kind of did a little copy-paste action.
I didn't check my ego at the door.
Mm-hmm. You, Obi, Anthony, Jim, and Kenny all required solo recording
solo
sessions.
Solo performances.
That's right, Sam, you tell them.
In that, I'm not a fucking seal.
Right.
I'm not Mr. Fucking Tap Dance Boy for you.
And Tim Reed was sent in because he's not allowed on premises.
Oh, is that happening? Is that what happened?
Yeah, it was
not allowed on premises.
Let's say hi to Q in New Orleans. Q.
What up, boys?
Hey, buddy.
Q.
First of all, I got to say, Quincy Jones, that's how you produce.
Yeah.
All right? And this is you guys' Star Trek, all right? The hardcore fans will love it. They'll get all the little tidbits, but it's very accessible to the common person on the street.
Yeah, right on.
You don't have to be a fan to appreciate the brilliance and beauty and majesty.
Safe
of
to
song.
Say, I think we have the second best version of the We Are the World song.
I think so.
And a lot of people out there are doing their own versions.
Yes.
I think this beats... There's the first version, there's this version, and then there's the 25th anniversary.
Yeah, which is forgettable.
Right. Yeah.
This one, though, wow.
People asking where was Larry King. Like Sam said, and we can't fit it all in, unfortunately.
I mean, we could have done We Are the World with just Anthony doing voices.
Which we still could do.
That's a very short walk from the studio to the elevator.
It would take a while.
It's very difficult.
Yeah. Well, Corinne has something on this. Corinne in Jersey. Corinne.
Guys, I laughed. I cried. I threw up in my mouth a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah. That's the feeling everybody's
getting.
This
is what we try to do, is get people to react. I don't care which way you react. Just react.
Emotions.
Tim, Toronto. Point. Enough of these Toronto calls today. Jesus, you have anything to do up there today?
Amazing.
We're stuck in a big pile of snow, so
in the club.
I'd call in. But, you know, Chip Chipperson gets a lot of shit on the show. For, like, lame-ass jokes and whatnot. Dude really? Had the funniest line in the whole song with the whole lend a hand, lend a foot.
A shoulder.
Some shoulders or something.
That fucking stopped me
perhaps,
on my track.
Perhaps.
Came out of nowhere. It was hilarious.
Awesome. All right.
That was ad-lib, too, by Chip. That was not written for him.
Wow.
Yep.
Yeah, Chip, I don't think ad-lib. Chip does much writing. I think everything he says is ad-lib. So, no, it was great. And the whole song, everything was fantastic. All right. Good job, guys.
You know what? Let's not get crazy, though. Let's not all of a sudden start producing bits for this show. That's, you know.
Yeah.
We don't need to do that.
We were thinking that maybe we would start bringing you guys in a lot more. Like, you and Ant could start being in a lot more.
We have a formula that's worked over the years. I wouldn't want to fuck with it.
Where you guys just go home?
Exactly.
Okay,
we come in, we do the minimal possible, then we leave. See, that's a formula that's worked for years.
I mean, you're very successful. It's hard
to
argue that.
Yes. Why fuck the whole thing up by, you know, producing bits, coming in, late.
Yeah. I'm saying late.
Early, late.
Early, late.
And how funny is it to look at Sam and see that he has to really work hard?
Oh, I know. I know. Look at him.
You're in that stage. It's
he
fun.
Works hard.
Enjoy it.
Ew.
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 Troy and I were sending versions of this song back and forth until like 9 o'clock at night last night.
Oh, wow.
Jesus. Making sure it was just so.
I was so bored, I was trying to figure out what I could do last night.
I was
just so bored. I'm like, man, I have nothing to do.
Well, I mean,
maybe I could have helped out. Brian in Massachusetts. Brian.
Yes, I'm sitting at my desk right now listening, and I think I'm about to get fired. I'm laughing so loud.
Yeah, that was very funny.
When
Kenny kicked in.
Yeah.
That really brought it right into your face. Because the music starts, and then Mustard, here comes the child, heed a sudden call, and then Kenny. It's fucking great.
Yeah. Well, we're going to take a break. We're going to replay the song at 9 o'clock. Why not?
Look at just you. So you. Look at you. Just so you are now like a jock.
I'm trying it.
I like it.
Just so you can pick up on some of the things you missed. Give me a list of all the people and how they appear in the song so we could tweet that so they could follow along as we play the song again. After the break, Boner's Parents Walk Off, Larry King. We'll do your SeaWorld update. Steven Tyler news, Stone Temple Pilots news. Don't have time to talk about this cop-out movie, unfortunately. Very, very busy today, Anthony.
Damn.
Extremely busy. We would love to, obviously.
I know.
We would love to do the right thing, but we just don't have time for that.
Talking about
today.
Tracy.
And other things. Stay there. Opie and Anthony. What do you got over there, Ed? Some breaking news?
I was just looking at the Idol news, you know, American Idol news. And it says, you may be upset or relieved to hear the news that Howard Stern definitely won't be joining American Idol as a judge replacing Simon Cowell. According to sources close to the show, the new judge will be announced at the end of the current run. And whoever gets the gig will have a sweet deal. No, that won't be happening.
Well, you got to give Howard a lot of credit. He's the biggest bullshit artist in radio.
Well,
and I give him credit for that, for real, because he's got people that know how to plant fake stories that the mainstream media, because they know the mainstream media in general is a bunch of dummies.
Pick up on it.
So they come up with a bullshit fucking lie. He's got the right people to feed it to the proper people. And then it becomes this big, huge, over-the-top thing.
Yep. And now I guess that can't be used as far as a tool here.
Yeah.
As far as certain things go.
Wow. The One, We Are the World song, which we're going to play again in about 20 minutes, features Mustard, then Club Soda Kenny, then Roland, then Uncle Paul, then Tank Hankerus, then The Virus, Stalker Patty, Lyle Chip Chipperson, Bobo, Steve C., Big A, Pat Fromanaki, Ted Sheckler, Opie, Sandy Kane, Auto-Tune Kenny, Master Poe, Annoying Guy from K-Rock, which was Tim, Bobo Springsteen, and then Tippy Tom.
Wow.
And this list will be online in a few minutes.
And then you could listen and try to, you know, pick out who they are.
Yeah.
Oh, that was so much fun 25 years ago doing that with the original.
Was it?